Rising levels of inflation have been wreaking havoc around the world. However, most industries have already adjusted their prices to maintain profit margins and have pushed the burden onto the end consumer. One industry that hasn't had the same luck, though, is dairy production, which now stands on the brink of a looming crisis. Milk production falls due to soaring costs. The plight of dairy farmers in the UK isn't anything new, as the pandemic and Brexit had already increased costs to an unsustainable level. This recent hike in prices, though, may have broken the camel's back. The sharp increase in global inflation due to the war in Ukraine has turbocharged the costs, and now it seems like the entire industry is heading towards doom. According to the farmers themselves, there's been a trade-off somewhere. Either the price of milk needs to go up to maintain healthy profit margins, or the milk production will continue to fall. The situation is pretty alarming, as this is the first time we've seen a drop in the production of milk over the past 8 years. And Arla Foods, which is Britain's largest dairy cooperative, has already sounded the alarms to brace for milk shortage in the future if things don't improve. It is unsustainable. The cost of producing milk is increasing like never before, and our farmers are continuing to experience significant inflation. It offers no profitability for farmers anymore, said the managing director of Arla Foods UK, Ash Amiramadi. But how much did the cost of milk even increase to trigger such a dire situation? And have we seriously not seen any hike in the price of milk in the past decade? Surely that doesn't sound right, right? Well, the answer may actually surprise you, so let's break it down. The price of milk for end consumers. Before we inspect the increase in the cost of milk production, let's divert our attention to the price first. In a normal circumstance, you'd assume that the price of milk has risen over the past decade, right? Everything else has gotten expensive, so milk has to follow suit as well. After all, that's the way inflation works. The reality, though, is that not only has the price of a pint of milk not increased over the past decade, but it has already gone down, which just doesn't sound real. Most shops have been supplying milk to consumers at a lower price than they were in 2012. Surely that would be outrageously bad for the dairy farmers, though, right? Well, not quite. You see, while the prices have remained stagnant for the end consumer, the farmers' earnings have increased. That's because Arla has increased its farm gate prices by 31% to almost 38p per liter over the past year. Some other supermarkets have also direct contracts with the farmers, which have been decent enough for the past few years. The recent hikes in cost, however, is making even these improved terms impossible to deal with. How much does it cost to produce a pint of milk? We've seen that farmers have gotten a better deal from both Arla and supermarkets for their milk production. But why are they still not good enough? How has the cost of milk protection even spiraled out of control like this? Let's dig into it. According to the latest official figures, the cost of a pint of milk has increased by 17%, from 42p to 49p. However, while 17% is not a figure to scoff at and is still super high for a single year, there are other things we need to account for as well. There are other factors at play for the increase in costs. You see, a dairy farmer's main costs are feed, fuel, and fertilizer. And if you've been following the news for the past year, you'd know that all three of these have seen a massive hike in price. For instance, the price of diesel for tractors has hovered around 62p mark last year. This year, though, we've already seen it reach the lofty heights of a pound and 29 pence. And it doesn't stop there either. The biggest cost of maintaining cows for any dairy farmer is the feed. And to get through the entire year, farmers make sure that suppliers are committed to a price and everything sorted for a few months at least. However, due to the current situation of global politics and the pandemic, the markets are incredibly volatile, and merchants are just not comfortable with committing to a price for the winter. In fact, the costs are climbing at such a high rate that a farmer with 1,000 cows would have to spend an extra 120,000 pounds to get the same amount of feed as last year. That's an astonishingly high increase of 100 quid per ton. And if it wasn't enough of a bombshell, then wait till you hear about the fertilizer prices. When compared proportionally, the fertilizer price hike leaves everything else in its wake. You could get a ton of urea fertilizer for around 310 pounds last year. Now, that price has tripled to 930 pounds. That's a 300% increase, which just shouldn't exist in the modern economy. And if we crunch the numbers for a farmer with 1,000 cows, that's a 60,000 pound increase in fertilizer bill in just a year. Increasing efficiency isn't enough anymore. Now, these are not small numbers by any stretch of the imagination. imagination. Imagine your costs going up by hundreds of thousands of pounds due to inflation alone. Not a great sight. In the past, dairy farmers have been pretty good at tackling inflation by increasing efficiency and increasing their scale. However, when the prices reach these unprecedented levels, then it becomes almost impossible to absorb extra costs. With that said, it's not like the retailers aren't trying to keep up either. Earlier this week, the UK retailer Tesco increased the price it pays for all its fresh milk by over 6 pence per liter. This is almost a 20% increase for all the dairy farmers that supply to Tesco. Other companies like Arla and Müller have also committed to higher and more competitive prices for their suppliers. Despite all of this work going into it, it seems like there are problems in other areas as well that are threatening these organic milk farms. Organic dairy sales are incredibly low in the UK. Organic dairy, for the longest time, has been one of the top performing sectors in the UK. However, things have started to unravel a bit for them, and lately there are doubts over the general demand for organic milk. We've already seen how the costs of producing organic milk have increased over the past year. It would have been fine if the consumers were still interested in buying that milk at a higher price, but it seems like the demand for organic milk is already waning at an alarming rate, even at these lower, unsustainable prices. As compared to other European countries like France or Germany, the UK has seen almost no growth in the demand for organic dairy goods. And when we look at the actual numbers, the situation is even more dire than we realize. Only 5% of milk and 1% of cheese sales in the UK are organic. In comparison, more than one-third of milk sales in Denmark are fully organic. So it seems like consumers prefer conventional milk brands even when they are sometimes more expensive. Farmers ponder over switching away from organic milk. That's not the only competition that's eating away at organic dairy sales, though. Over the past few years, we've seen the rise in alternative milk types like oat, almond, and soy milk, and the demand for these only seems to be going up. So it seems like the recent trends really aren't favorable for organic milk farmers, and if these rising costs aren't dealt with, then some of these farmers could even make the switch. After all, conventional milk is easier to manufacture and fetches a higher price in the market as well. Not only that, but the organic farming standards are also being diluted every day as conventional milk companies also adopt similar standards. This means that there isn't really much separating organic dairy from conventional on the store shelves, with the latter looking way more attractive to consumers thanks to its health benefit claims. How do they tackle these issues, though? According to the Soil Association's farming director, Liz Bowles, the key is to stop relying on imported feed in the long term. She explained that switching over to homegrown proteins like peas and beans, and making sure that cows are mostly eating a diet that consists of grass and forage, will go a long way toward reducing these spiraling organic dairy costs. There's also an issue with advertising and marketing when it comes to organic. There just aren't enough buzzwords being used to market the benefits to the end consumer. So those who visit supermarkets don't really have an incentive to buy organic milk over conventional milk. That's a wrap for this video. Do you think that organic dairy farmers need to adapt to the changing times to survive? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.